Before the calorimeter, all they could do was evaluate what went in the mouth and what came out from the other end, but they didn't know how valuable the feedstuff was to the animal. A calorimeter determines the amount of heat production of an animal in the calorimeter. When a ruminant consumes feedstuffs, some of that energy is wasted as heat, and other energy in the feedstuff is used for production of either protein or fat. And what the calorimeter does is determines how well the animal converts the feedstuff into body energy.
The calorimeter is important to keep here because of the historical perspective that it brings to this. And the fact that there are not many facilities like this around today for people to be able to see. And as much as, you know, we talk about technology and the way things move forward and miniaturization of everything, the opportunity to see a facility or a tool like this really puts it into students' minds so that they can understand concepts that there's no way to be able to get them as excited about in class that we can when we bring them here. I use the calorimeter very much as a teaching tool for many of the classes in animal nutrition that I teach today. So we have students, mainly I work with students in the animal science department here at Penn State, and we have students that are interested in nutrition and learning more about that and sort of the future of animal nutrition. And as much as the calorimeter is very much a historical building, it also offers a very unique opportunity for those students that are learning about nutrition, that are learning about energy, to see some of the history of how that was studied and to understand a lot of the things that we're talking about in class, so they can see and understand a lot of the things that I might lecture about. They can actually see it kind of in practice here, or see how some of those things were determined.